Hello, welcome to Dentalk. I'm Dr. Simon Pardiñas, a specialist in oral surgery and periodontology. Today we're going to speak about dental calculus or TARTAR. Dental tartar is a very widespread oral problem. In this video, we're going to address why it is formed, what consequences it can have, and how it can be removed. Dental tartar, or dental calculus, is a calcification of bacterial dental plaque that accumulates around the teeth. Dental plaque, or biofilm, is a sticky, whitish substance that adheres to the surface of the tooth. This plaque can be easily removed by brushing, but if it's not done correctly, it can calcify due to the minerals present in the saliva and give rise to the aforementioned tartar. Dental calculus is formed by the precipitation of minerals present in saliva, such as calcium and phosphorus. This tartar has a yellowish or brown appearance, with a rough surface, and it can't be removed by normal brushing. These are the main reasons for its development. The main cause of tartar formation is the lack of hygiene, which causes an accumulation of dental plaque on the surface of the teeth. An incorrect brushing technique can also have these consequences. Another important factor is each person's saliva's composition. The pH of saliva ranges from 6.5 to 7. An acidic pH can favor the demineralization of teeth and the appearance of cavities, but a basic pH favors the formation of dental calculus. The consumption of certain foods can cause the saliva pH to vary, and thus favor the appearance of calculus on the teeth. It is known by this name to the tartar that forms especially in swimmers, who require to spend a longer time in contact with the pool water. It usually occurs especially in professional athletes. The pH of saliva is normally between 6.5 and 7, while the pH of swimming pool water is usually between 7.2 and 7.6. This difference in levels favors the appearance of calculus on the teeth. Depending on the location where it is formed, two types of tartar are described. Supragingival tartar is located above the gum and is visible to the naked eye. It is less harmful and easier to remove. Subgingival tartar is located at the root of the tooth below the gum and is not visible to the naked eye. This subgingival tartar is the most dangerous, since it is one of the causes of periodontal disease. In order to detect this tartar, it is important to perform x-rays and a periodontal probing. Millions of bacteria accumulate in dental plaque and tartar that can cause various problems. Tartar can be one of the triggers of tooth decay, an infection disease caused by bacteria that exist in the mouth. When we consume sugary products or hydrates, these bacteria, during their metabolism, create acids capable of destroying tooth enamel. Tartar is one of the main causes of periodontal disease. We speak of gingivitis when this disease causes inflammation of the gum, but does not affect the dental bone. In case of affecting the bone structure, then we would speak of periodontitis. The accumulation of tartar and plaque on the teeth and other parts of the mouth is one of the main causes of halitosis, or bad breath. Multiple recent studies link the bacteria present in dental plaque and tartar with heart problems, arthritis, colon cancer, brain strokes, etc. In addition to the health problems already mentioned, tartar has a negative aesthetic effect, as it can give teeth a dark and dirty appearance. As the stone is a compact, mineralized structure, it is not removed by simple brushing, and depending on the depth at which it is found, the treatment will vary. This common type of cleaning is enough to remove supragingival tartar, that is, the one above the gum. This periodontal prophylaxis includes the use of instruments such as ultrasounds and curettes, used especially to remove tartar from the surface of the teeth. Scaling and root planning is a technique used to remove subgingival tartar, that is, tartar that is under the gum but is not yet too deep. It is performed under local anesthesia, using instruments called curettes that are inserted through the gum to reach the tartar that is attached to the surface of the roots. The objective is to eliminate the tartar and the toxins generated by the bacteria accumulated in it that cause the gum to become inflamed. If this subgingival tartar is very deep and the access through the gum does not allow it to be removed, it will be necessary to undertake periodontal surgery. This treatment consists of making incisions in the gum to separate it and to be able to correctly access the entire contour of the root. In this way, we can remove tartar, polish the surface of the roots to prevent reaccumulation of tartar, remove the affected gum tissue, recontour the bone around the tooth if necessary, and finally suture the gum. This treatment means that the gums will be in a lower position, so there will be more spaces between the teeth and will give a longer tooth appearance. These new spaces created between the teeth will be the ones that are very important to clean correctly, using specific interdental or interproximal brushes. It is very important that in addition to brushing after each meal, floss and use interproximal brushes when necessary. This can prevent the formation of plaque and tartar between the teeth and prevent cavities. It is advisable to use a brush of medium hardness and with the correct technique to avoid damaging the gums due to excessive pressure. Also, we must not forget to clean the tongue correctly. The tongue is the part of the mouth that accumulates the most bacteria. Hence, it is important to clean it regularly. For this, the toothbrush itself or specific instruments called tongue scrapers can be used. Although the daily hygiene routine at home is the most important thing, it is advisable to go to the dentist at least twice a year and perform the professional dental prophylaxis recommended by your dentist. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and you can leave all your doubts in the comments of the videos. Muchas gracias.